Dear students, welcome to the online lecture series of environmental science. We are in the fourth unit of environmental science or the environmental studies. In this unit, we are discussing environmental laws. In the very first lecture of this unit, I introduced you the environmental laws. What are the environmental laws? What are the provisions? And in the very beginning, I also discussed about Article 48A and 51AG. Today, we are going to discuss a very important topic, and that is Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1974. Every act or rule or a provision has its specific objective, and as far as the Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1974 is concerned, as the name indicates, it is related to the prevention and control of water pollution. It provides provisions, rules and regulations for maintaining and restoring the wholesome water by preventing and controlling its pollution, be it a surface water or be it a groundwater, and is to restore the quality of water or to maintain the quality of water in its original position. If we define what is pollution, we all know, if we consider a water pollution, we have three properties of water, that's physical, chemical and biological properties of water, be it a color, be it a turbidity, be it pH, be it conductivity, etc. And chemical properties like dissolved oxygen, fixed carbon dioxide, amount of oxygen available, nitrates, phosphate, etc. available in the water. And similarly, biological properties of water, what are the organisms existing on that very particular water? It may be a phytoplankton, zooplankton, nectans, fish, etc. And if the water is very much contaminated or polluted, there may be a presence of pathogenic organisms like Salmonella typhi, etc., etc. So if we simply define what is pollution, we can conceptualize three different properties of water: physical, chemical and biological properties of water, and any change, but the change must be undesirable in nature. Undesirable. If there is a change which is undesirable in nature, be it in the form of physical properties, chemical properties or biological properties of water, due to addition of some foreign substances, be it a fertilizer, it may be a pesticide, it may be industrial wastes in the form of acids, in the form of alkalis, in the form of toxic substances, etc. So to regulate these things, there is an act for preventing such intrusion of pollutants into the water, be it a surface or groundwater. An act is already provided, which is known as Water Prevention and Control of Act 1974. So if we simply define what is pollution, we can define undesirable change in physical, chemical and biological properties of water due to addition of any foreign substance is simply known as water pollution. Or we may also define the water pollution as contamination of water or such alteration of physical, chemical or biological properties of water or such discharge is likely to cause a nuisance or render the water harmful, injuries for public health or the living organisms existing on that very water body or the water which is consumed by any other human being, living creatures on that, on the vicinity of that water bodies. Thus, the water pollution encompasses the entire probable agents in water that may cause or any harm or a potential to harm any kind of life in that water body. If we discuss the silent features of the water pollution, first silent feature of the act is, first, it provides maintenance and restoration of, it provides maintenance and restoration of both surface and surface and groundwater. Means the act has a provision which can maintain one thing and restore the quality of both surface and groundwater. Means the Water Act has a provision that can maintain the status of water. Maintain the status of water means if the water is in such a condition as we have four different stages of water. First is oligotrophic, very lowest amount of nutrients or lowest status of pollution. Then we have mesotrophic, comparatively a higher level of pollutants in the form of nitrates and phosphates are present. And third very stage of water, eutrophic, comparatively very much contaminated or polluted. In the fourth stage, this is diastrophic stage. And what we are supposed to do, we are supposed to maintain the quality of water. If any water body, for example, is in a mesotrophic stage, then the act comes on that very water body in the form of implementation so that the status of water in the mesotrophic can be maintained so that no further deterioration of water takes place towards the eutrophic or towards the diastrophic stage. Means we are supposed to maintain the status of water in that very position, jis position mein bhi aapka water hai, usi position status mein agar hum maintain rakhte water ki quality ko, then we call this maintenance of water body. Similarly, the restoration of water body. Restoration means if the water body has got already polluted, say for example, in the form of eutrophic stage. Eutrophic means comparatively a higher status of pollution in the water bodies is a eutrophic stage. Then what we are supposed to do? We are supposed to implement such practices or such laws which can bring back the eutrophic stage of water again into mesotrophic or oligotrophic stage of water. Means water body बहुत ज़्यादा pollute हो चुका है, उसको अगर हम laws के implementation के through further intrusion of pollutants से बचा के उसको एक स्टैंडर्ड प्रोवाइड करके अगर हम इस यूट्रोफिक स्टेज को फिर दोबारा से रेस्टोर करके फिर दोबारा से अगर हम अच्छे से स्टेज में लाते हैं, स्टेटस में लाते हैं, जिसको हमने ओलिगोट्रॉफिक स्टेज कहा, देन वी कॉल दिस द रेस्टोरेशन ऑफ वाटर बॉडी. रेस्टोरेशन ऑफ वाटर बॉडी मीन्स टू ब्रिंग बैक द डिग्रेडेड क्वालिटी ऑफ वाटर बॉडी इनटू एन इट इज ओरिजिनल पोजिशन और टू अ लोअर लेवल ऑफ पोल्यूशन स्टेटस. देन इट प्रोवाइड्स फॉर द एस्टेब्लिशमेंट ऑफ सेंट्रल एंड स्टेट बोर्ड्स फॉर पोल्यूशन कंट्रोल. इट प्रोवाइड्स फॉर एस्टेब्लिशमेंट ऑफ सेंट्रल एंड स्टेट बोर्ड्स. सेंट्रल बोर्ड मीन्स सीपीसीबी एंड स्टेट बोर्ड्स मीन्स एसपीसीबी. सेंटर पोल्यूशन कंट्रोल बोर्ड एंड स्टेट पोल्यूशन कंट्रोल बोर्ड इज द केस में भी मीन्स वाटर प्रिवेंशन एंड कंट्रोल ऑफ पोल्यूशन एक्ट 1974 प्रोवाइड्स फॉर द एस्टेब्लिशमेंट ऑफ सेंट्रल एंड स्टेट बोर्ड्स, बी इट सेंट्रल पोल्यूशन कंट्रोल बोर्ड वी से सीपीसीबी और स्टेट पोल्यूशन कंट्रोल बोर्ड वी से एसपीसीबी. द एस्टेब्लिशमेंट ऑफ बोर्ड means the board is comprising of experts from the different fields, especially the scientists who knows how to control and how to abate, how to mitigate the pollution of water, and what are the advancements in the market in the form of technology is available for controlling these water pollution. That's why the CPCB, Central Pollution Control Board, or SPCB, the members of CPCB or SPCB is belong to different fields which know how to control and abate, how to mitigate the pollution of water. The Act has a provision of as we all know to run any industry or any agency we are supposed to need funds, and the Act has a provision for funds. It has a provision for funds. Act has provision for funds, budgets, accounts and auditing of the central and control, central pollution control board and state pollution control board. Means the act, it has a provision of funds, provision of funds, budgets, accounts and audit. Means water prevention and control of pollution has a provision to provide funds for prevention and control of water pollution and budgeting of those funds and audit of their accounts. Means where the fund has been made expenditure, whether the funds are properly utilized or not, and while utilizing the funds, whether the caudal formalities are being kept or adhered to. Means the provision of funds, budgets and auditing of their accounts. And the Act, Water Act, has a provision for penalties for defaulters. It has provision for penalties for defaulters. If you have been given a proper standard, if you are an industrialist, if you are running a unit and your industry or the unit is discharging an amount of pollution, and you are already given a proper standard how much amount of pollutants you are supposed to discharge, if you limit that very pollution level within the permissible limit already given by Ministry of Environment and Forest or the laws, but if your pollution, your industry's pollution level exceeds the limit already given, then you become a defaulter and there are penalties are already fixed for such defaulters. Means if you are polluting the water body either by your industrialization activities or by any other means, then you become a defaulter and penalties are already finalized. How much amount of penalties in the form of imprisonment, in the form of fine, and sometimes both may be imposed. So penalties are set or fixed for such defaulters. The main function of the regulation of the water prevention and control is by regulating authorities, and these regulating authorities are Central Pollution Control Board, Central Pollution Control Board, or we say CPCB. Means at center level there is a board known as CPCB or SPCB, which has different functions, and the prime motive or the function of such board is to control and maintain both the quality of water and restore it into its original position, be it a surface or groundwater. What can be the functions of Central and State Pollution Control Board? We may discuss. For example, as we already know, CPCB has expert member in its board. So it advises the central government, it advises the central government in matters related to prevention and control of water pollution. Prevention and control of water pollution. Having been experts in the CPCB or SPCB, as the case may be, it advises the central government. No doubt, central pollution is CPCB. Is comparatively having a less power as compared to the central government, but Having been of an expert committee in the CPCB, CPCB advises the central government as it is not necessary that the government running bodies may not be an expert from a particular field. That's why CPCB is supposed to advise central government about the matters related to the prevention and control of water pollution. Because CPCB has members which are experts from the particular concern field. It also shows a very important function of coordinating the activities of State Pollution Control Board. Means different states having different state pollution control boards, and to coordinate the activities of such state boards and provisions of technical assistance and guidance is also a provision in the CPCB. Means what I'm trying to say that there is a provision of coordination of SPCBs comparatively having more power by the CPCB. It coordinates the activities of the state pollution control boards working in different states and coordinate their activities and provide technical assistance. CPCB provides technical assistance to the state pollution control boards, and if any guidance needed by the SPCB, then the CPCB is supposed to provide technical assistance and guidance and supposed to coordinate the activities of State Pollution Control Board in different states in matters relating to the prevention and control of water pollution. In the next very lecture, we will proceed the remaining portion of this law. Till then, stay home, stay safe, best of luck.